Assalamualaikum, hi my dear students, welcome back to our English class. Today we are going to learn a beautiful lesson. Okay, so the lesson name is The Nightingale and the Rose. What is the lesson name? The Nightingale and the Rose. So this lesson is from the part 2 book. Okay, part 2 book, we have poems. In the beginning you have poem, that is the unit name is Flowers and Showers. The first poem is Song of the Flower, that I have sent you through audio, and second poem also. This lesson first showers, next poem, and this one is third lesson. Okay, lesson 3. This lesson is a very beautiful lesson, and it will tell you a message. Tragic end. Okay, tragic end means sad end you will get after learning this lesson, reading this lesson. Okay, it's a very beautiful lesson. That's why I am taking as video. Okay, so that lesson name is The Nightingale of the Rose. The Nightingale of the Rose. Nightingale, what do you mean by nightingale? Nightingale is a bird. Okay, nightingale is a bird. So who has written this beautiful lesson? Page number 139, Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde is a very famous writer. Okay, he is a very famous writer, and we are going to see about him. Oscar Wilde, 1954, 1900, was an Irish poet, fiction writer, and essayist. He is considered as a central figure in aesthetic writing and a master short story writer. Okay, and a master short story writer. He was a staunch advocate of the art of art's sake. His major plays include A Woman of No Importance. So what are the works he was written? A Woman of No Importance, An Ideal Husband, and The Importance of Being Earnest. This is very famous novel. The Importance of Being Earnest, and the novel The Picture of Dorian Gray. In 1888, he wrote poems and published The Happy Prince and Other Tales, a collection of children's stories. Later, he published a collection of essays arguing the tenets of atheism. Okay, so this is about him. Now we are going into the story. The story is, in the end, we feel very sad. That is tragic end. Okay, we don't know what will happen. We are going to see step by step what in the story, and we are going to enjoy the story also. Okay, at some point in our life we realize that nature soothes us and shares our pains. Does nature help us when we are in trouble or in need? They are asking question. Okay, does nature help us when we are in trouble or in need? Read a story about how nature helps man in times of need. So this is a story about how nature helps a man in times of need. Okay, the nature is helping one man. Okay, we are going to see that. She said that she would dance with me if I brought her red roses, cried the young student. But all my garden, there is no red rose. So this is the first character. He was speaking, okay, by himself. Okay, he was speaking by himself. So here one picture they have given. So this is the young boy, okay, young student. About him only we are going to study. So he was telling, he was speaking by himself. She said she would dance with me if I brought her red roses. So the young student was telling, one girl, she told me she will dance with me if I brought her a red roses. Understand? So the young student was telling to us, okay, she will dance with me if I brought her a red roses to her. Okay, this young boy was telling. Cried the young student, but in all my garden there is no red rose. So now we can understand the young boy was fall in love with a beautiful girl. Okay, the young boy fall in love with a beautiful girl. The girl wants a red rose. Okay, so the boy was telling by himself, she will dance with me if I brought a red rose. Okay, he was telling by himself, in my garden there is no red rose. Okay, the boy was telling, in my garden there is no red rose, how can I dance with her? Okay, the young boy was telling by himself. From her nest in the oak tree, the nightingale heard him and she looked out through the leaves and wondered. So, can you see the picture? The boy was sitting under a oak tree. Okay, oak is a type of tree. Okay, it's look like this. So, the boy was sitting under the oak tree. Okay, oak tree. This is spelling. Oak tree. So he was sitting under the oak tree and he was speaking by himself. Okay, but one person was heard. Who is that? The oak tree. Okay, so in this lesson we are going to see that the nature also responding to the human being. Okay, even the any animals or any trees, the nature also responding to the human being. So the boy was telling by himself, but one person was heard. Who is that? The oak tree. Okay, the oak tree heard that from her nest. So from her nest in the oak tree, the nightingale, the oak tree also hearing from the oak tree. The nightingale heard him. Okay, nightingale is a beautiful bird. Okay, actually one poem is there, nightingale, wonderful poem is there about nightingale. Okay, so I think it was written by John Keats. Okay, the bird was sitting in the oak tree. Okay, the bird was sitting in the oak tree. So this is a tree. This is the oak tree. And here the bird was, the nightingale was. Okay, sitting. The nightingale was sitting and heard the speech of whom? The little boy. The little boy was sitting here. Okay. The boy is here. Okay. Just you have to imagine. Okay, imagination is very, very important. Then only we can enjoy the story. So this is the oak tree. In that oak tree, the nightingale was sitting in the branches and heard the words of the little young boy. What he was telling? I want to dance with the girl if I brought the red rose. Okay, he was telling. And then what happened? She looked out through the leaves and wondered. So the nightingale was looking She looked through the leaves and wondered. She was looking through the leaves and wondered. "No red rose in all my garden," he cried. So the little boy, again he was telling, "No red rose in my garden," he cried. His beautiful eyes are filled with tears. So the boy was very, very beautiful, and the tears are coming. Tears are coming from his eyes. "And what little things does happiness depend? I have read all that the wise men have written, and all the secrets of philosophy are mine. Yet for want a red rose is my life made wretched." So what I was telling, whatever it may be, I have read all the wise men I have written. So all the secrets of philosophy of mine, I have read so many books, but now I was want the red rose. Okay, I want the red rose, he was telling. "Here at last is a true lover," said the nightingale. "Night after night I sung for him, though I know him not. Night after night I have told a story to the stars. Now I see him." So here the nightingale now speaking. Okay, the bird itself speaking. What the bird was speaking, "Here at last is a true lover." Okay, so the nightingale was sitting in the oak tree, and the nightingale is watching each and every action and words of the little boy. And the nightingale was telling, "Here I saw a true lover." Okay, true. Okay, that is very, very important. "Night after night I sung of him, though I know him not. Night after night I have told a story to the stars. Now I saw him. His hair is dark as the hyacinth blossom. His lips are red as the rose of his desire. But passion has made his face like pale ivory, and sorrow has set a seal upon his brow." So the nightingale was describing the little boy, how the boy was very, very beautiful. Okay, and the nightingale was telling his beauty. In the same way, the boy was very, very sad also. That also the nightingale was telling. "The prince gives a ball tomorrow night." So this is a very long lesson. After watching my video, you must read the text. You can enjoy the story. This is a very famous story, "Nightingale and the Rose" by Oscar Wilde. Very famous story. Okay, so you can enjoy step by step what is the story. Okay, so after seeing the video, you must watch the watch the video, and you must read the textbook also. Okay, so I will continue the same lesson in next class. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum.